What do you need to know about vitamin B12? Stick around and find out. Welcome to the Treyarch Channel. I am Ray Upchurch, your host, and today we are talking about vitamin B12, also called cobalamin. Like the other B vitamins, vitamin B12 is a water-soluble vitamin. That being said, like the other water-soluble vitamins, the excess can be excreted, but unlike some of them, it can also be stored in the liver, for when supplies are scarce. These stores can last for a whole year, which is why it takes a long time before people realize that they are deficient. Vitamin B12 is required for neurological function, DNA synthesis, and proper red blood cell formulation. As vitamin B12 can only be manufactured by certain bacteria and can only be found naturally in animal products, the only other way to get it is through other fortified foods. The recommended daily allowance of vitamin B12 for children between 0 to 6 months is 0.4 micrograms. For children 7 to 12 months, it's 0.5 micrograms. For 1 to 3 years old, it's 0.9 micrograms. And for 4 to 8 years old, it's 1.2 micrograms. For 9 to 13 years old, it's 1.8 micrograms. And for 14 and older, it's 2.4 micrograms. Unless they're pregnant, then it's 2.6. Or if they're breastfeeding, it's 2.8 micrograms. So what happens if we have too much vitamin B12? Fortunately, there have not been any health risks noted with the intake of too much vitamin B12. That being said, it should be noted that the USDA has reduced the daily suggested value from 6 micrograms to what it is today. So, if you want to make sure you're taking the right dose, or before you take it, you should contact your doctor. The effects of not having enough vitamin B12 include megaloblastic anemia, fatigue, constipation, loss of appetite, weight loss, neurological changes to include numbness and tingling of the hands and feet. Other symptoms include depression, difficulty maintaining balance, confusion, dementia, poor memory, and soreness of the mouth. The fortunate thing is that when these neurological changes occur, they cannot be reversed. The groups most at risk of vitamin B12 deficiency are older adults, individuals with pernicious anemia, individuals with gastrointestinal disorders, individuals who had bypass surgeries, vegetarians, pregnant and lactated women who follow a strict vegetarian diet, and their infants. Some of the top foods that contain vitamin B12 are clams with 3,502% the daily value per 3 ounces, liver with 3,035% per 3 ounces, mackerel with 1,346% per 6 ounces, king crab at 642% per crab leg, beef skirt at 533% per 6 ounce, fortified cereals with 254% per 3 quarters cup, fortified tofu with 137% per cup, low-fat milk with 108% per 6 ounce glass, Swiss cheese at 36% per ounce, eggs at 23% per large eggs. For vegans and vegetarians, you can also have fortified juice, which is 250% per cup, unsweetened soy milk, which is 249% per 16 ounces, low-fat yogurt, which is 62% per cup, vitamin water, which is 25% per cup, and whey powder, which is only 7% per tablespoon. The Food and Drug Administration recommends getting your vitamins primarily from foods. When it comes to vitamins such as B12, This is particularly important because only a small portion is actually processed from the supplement form. This, with the added interactions with medications that either interfere or it interferes with them. So, how do you get your vitamin B12? Let me know in the comment section below. And thank you so much for joining me. If you've liked this video, please press the like button below. Also, if you're not a current subscriber, please subscribe and hit the bell icon so that you can be notified of any new videos when they come out. Remember, be part of health, and I will see you next time.